Hi, my name is Sandra. I'm educated as a social worker, so that's my formal recognition. I started in, I think, 2008, when I was working in with young people in the age between 14 and 16 years old, living in a residential care institution to go international and to work with youth councils and youth work situations. My interest in digital youth work started around 2014 when I started with using digital open badges in supporting youth councils with recognizing prior skills gained during these youth council meetings and starting to explore digital tools. And what I saw at that moment is that young people were very fast in discovering how a tool worked. And I discovered in my colleague youth workers that they were struggling a little bit with understanding the digital tools that are online and feeling a little bit silly when not understanding those digital tools. And for me, that recognition gave me some brave feelings as, oh, I'm not the only one. So let's start understanding and let's start learning. And what I have done at that moment, I have an iPhone, and on that iPhone, there is an app where you can see all kind of apps, the App Store, and they advertise apps to use for gamification or for social chats with other people, but also for managing projects. And I just started to download free apps. I didn't want to have the paid versions, but I downloaded free apps and started to learn how to use them and deleting them from my phone when I was ready with it. So I played some games. I tried out some managing tools. I tried out some different chat versions. And that is how I started to learn myself and asking people around how to use this. So I also discovered that time that in the youth council were a lot of young people who wanted to support me. So they started to become my teachers. That is one example how my interest started for digital youth work. And one other situation where I was quite often in is when I was doing projects in South Africa and in the locations where people live. And young people there don't have laptops or good internet connection. So what I've learned there is that I didn't want to accept that people don't have opportunities. So I was started to think, how can I solve this? How can I start using digital tools without good or reliable internet connection and tools? And what I've learned there is that I need to make people aware about their digital literacy opportunities. One other thing that I learned there is that we probably need to stop educating young people who will never use a laptop because they will find other jobs to learn to work with a laptop, but we need to teach young people in youth work activities to buy the right phone, because everything is in your phone, and the library on the corner or in your area can have Wi-Fi connection. But when young people don't have the right phone with enough storage, they cannot download the right app and cannot start learning. That is also what raised my interest in digital youth work. How can I teach, how can I educate young people doing youth work activities to use digital tools, use the internet, and try not to let them behind other young people who have those opportunities. I developed personally and professionally to be where I am right now in delivering digital youth work when we started to transfer a leadership course into a digital version of that leadership course, Effective Habits for Digital Youth Work Workers, we named it. And I started to grow my confidence by delivering youth work training and using many different digital tools with my colleague trainers and with other youth workers. What I have discovered in that period is that and I don't know if this is real, but for me it is real. There are two types of tools to be used on the internet. And then, for example, when you are developing a website, you can use the WordPress. Sorry, I forgot the WordPress. Or I can use a template-based website development tool. And I'm much better in using those tools which have templates than based on programming type of tools. Same it is for, I started to learn for 2 years Adobe programs And I didn't understand them. So also there, I'm now using Canva, which also has templates, and that works for me. So I stopped challenging myself with those other programming types and starting to use the template-based versions. And what I also, one of the very helping personally and professionally discoveries was that I started to realize that the digital world is changing very quick and keeps changing for the next decade or more decades. So I realized that I need to keep learning and that I never know everything about the digital tools that I want to use or what is possible on the internet. So my lifelong learning capacity needed to grow, and I started to do that. My next step is that I really would like to dive in virtual reality to work with young people. So I keep improving, I keep discovering, I keep challenging, I keep learning. Why I started to invest in digital youth work is that I saw there's a change in society and people are more and more using digital tools and the internet. And there I saw an opportunity to educate young people who learn very well within non-formal education by just organizing hands-on activities, start to developing together with young people activities or to co-design some tools that we want to deliver or a game together or publicity materials. I also started to co-manage projects with young people, and many of them were international. And I think the international youth work invites for being online because it's not always possible to travel. So I like to connect, for example, young people from South Africa together with the Dutch young people or the people from Curaçao and try to connect them. And then we need to support in how to be online and how to start a Zoom session, for example. I saw that people were struggling and wanted to help, to have support in that. What excites me about the digital youth work that I'm doing is personally it enables me to create awesome communication resources. I'm now able to promote youth work and what young people do in a much better way than before. And my professional reputation is growing due to this. Yeah, and I like that a lot. I'm working now also in a much more effective way by using management tools and shared collaboration spaces. So I have more time to do other things or work with young people. And at the same time, I can educate other people to start using these management tools and collaboration spaces. And they benefit from that too. Then what most excites me about this digital youth work is that I'm learning from young people and using several tools together with young people. And I am able to co-manage much more together with young people. For example, I understand Facebook, but I totally not understanding Instagram. I don't have the skill for Instagram and I don't know what makes that. I didn't discover that yet. But a young person is now doing the Instagram for me, and I like doing this together on an equal basis. We started with evaluating the impact of digital youth work practices by using competence models. And one of the competence models that we started to use is DIGCOMP, and especially the competence problem solving or digital problem solving, which is part of DIGCOMP. So we have started to research what level of skills young people have already in digital problem solving and looking, for example, how to use technology for problem solving. This was one of the main items in the project that we were running that time. And it was the starting point for me, for our organization to start using this and to make it conscious for ourselves. So we are not yet sure if we want to start using a real assessments for things like this or within youth work, not to have formal assessment, but how to start recognizing this in a way that it is also recognized by formal education or municipalities or businesses, for example. So that is still a path that we need to discover, but we are on our way and we are halfway, I think. Then another example is when together with young people, we carried on in-depth interviews about the Global Youth Skills Zone. This is a competence model created by Institute for the Future. And in these interviews, in these chats, we call them among young people. So young people are chatting with other young people about these global youth skill zones. They were telling, for example, that they are aware already that they need to learn how to use technical developments or machines, digital tools, but not yet know how to do it or what exactly is important to start using. Another thing that we saw in these interviews or chats is that young people are not always aware that they are already using a lot of, for example, digital assistants or robots. And when young people are aware, then this can be very helpful when they start searching for a job opportunity. So Befriend the Machines is one of the skill zones of the Global Youth Skills. And we started to discover, what is it exactly? How can we use it? How to connect with businesses that want to have young people with Befriend the Machine skills? And we did this together with young people, giving young people the lead during preparations and even running at a very cool festival from Mozilla, which happened recently, where young people were taking the lead and where we were able to find connections between formal education, youth work, and the business field. Because also people in the business field want to connect with youth work and start learning what young people want or start supporting young people to gain the skills that the businesses need. I grow my collaboration with other people and organizations and colleagues quite often via capacity building projects who are funded by Erasmus Plus. And we are learning and growing a lot as an organization from doing this capacity building projects. For example, we are at the moment in a project which is Digital Generation Youth, which is also talking and learning with colleagues about literacy programs. And for example, we organized a study visit in South Africa where we visited organizations working with digital literacy programs in South Africa, in a country where a lot of people struggle with connectivity and having the right tools. And learning from them how they are using the digital literacy programs was very much a collaboration where we learned and growth with each other. And what I still use when I'm trying to solve problems here in my youth work organization or when I talk with young people. So that is one of the examples. I also collaborate with others by organizing and being part of international training mobilities for youth workers, and where we organize staff training or where we organize leadership programs. And the growing of this network is very important in finding the right partners when you want to start a specific project. I also collaborate in participation in bigger European events where I started to share my experience and my learning in the work that I'm doing daily and learning from others during these events. And also there finding the right partners again to share what we are doing, to raise awareness what we are doing, to discover items in digital youth work that still needs to be worked on. And you see every time step by step that it becomes more professional, and being part of that is very nice and motivating. One other very important collaboration that we have that is the start of the Cities of Learning network. And being part of a network and learning and collaborating with partners and colleagues from organizations who are busy with similar situations with young people or similar themes that are important for organizations. And I, due to this network, also actually due to the digital youth work and the start of the Cities of Learning network, I am growing my national partnerships in the Netherlands. I'm finding there like-minded people, so people who have the same interest, but also I'm connecting with people with different skills, and then we are stronger together. Would like to recommend to other youth workers who want to develop digital youth work practices is start doing, try out, make mistakes and learn. And while doing that, connect with young people who are always very willing to learn together with you and educate you when you need education. And the third recommendation that I would like to give is find out what are the right digital tools for you. It is very important that you are finding them, and probably they are different than another person is using.